So in this ongoing journey, let's talk about chronic disease versus acute disease. We have already learned that we have to follow the middle path and we have to follow the five precepts. In acute illness, what we follow is, first we take a history, followed by a physical examination. We then prescribe investigations, whatever is available to us. We come to a provisional diagnosis and then we treat. When we follow this hierarchy, we do not make mistakes or we minimize our mistakes. In diabetes care, however, we tend to forget this and we jump straight to the treatment, we jump straight to the insulin preparation. That is where we make a mistake. So in diabetes also, you always have to take a history, do a physical examination, and then investigate. The English word is phenotype. Phenotype means the sum of all external attributes. So a medical phenotype would be my medical history and my physical examination findings. If we change this word to mean, we use the word glucophenotype, that means all angles of the medical history, physical examination, and the glucose values. This is a particular person's glucophenotype. Let's look at the glucophenotype. You can look at it from the history, physical examination point of view, but let's just look at the investigations. Now, fasting plasma glucose has its own value, postprandial has its own, and HbA has its own. If you have a person with predominantly high fasting plasma glucose, that person will require a different insulin regime, which will be basal insulin. If the person has normal or near normal fasting, but very high postprandial, the regime required will be different. If the person has an HbA1c of 8 or 8.5, we will be less aggressive. If the person has an HbA1c of 12 or 12.5, we will be more aggressive. So that's glucotype. But physical examination, supposing the patient has a comorbidity, which is life-threatening, organ-threatening, or limb-threatening, if glucose is not controlled immediately. For example, tuberculosis, a diabetic foot, a limb-threatening diabetic foot, a soft tissue infection, and a non-resolving pneumonia. In all these, you need intensive therapy. You cannot say that the American guidelines tell me to start basal insulin, so I will start basal and just wait for the insulin to act. In the meantime, tuberculosis or diabetic foot will have taken away the patient's life or organ or limb. So then we have to be intensive from the very beginning. On the other hand, the patient may have a comorbidity which puts the patient at high risk of hypoglycemia. So three endocrine causes which predispose to hypo: pituitary failure, thyroid failure, and adrenal failure. Hypopituitary, hypothyroid, hypoadrenal. Three medical causes to remember: renal impairment, hepatic impairment, gastrointestinal impairment. Gastrointestinal impairment may be gastroparesis, or it may be a motility disorder, it may be an absorption disorder. If the patient has any of these, then intensive insulin is not a good idea because the patient will go into hypo. So you start a soft insulin, start an insulin which has low risk of hypoglycemia, and start at very low dose. So all these things, when you look at the patient's glucophenotype, we will be able to understand what kind of a regime the patient needs and what kind of a preparation the patient needs. So in the developing world, we have many challenges. Cost is an issue, patient motivation is an issue, but by now we have realized that if we use our strengths and we just tend to follow the middle path in everything, you follow the five precepts in your daily practice, we usually will not make a mistake. And try to take the patient along with us in this journey. It is not that I am driving alone on the road. The patient is driving. I am there to help the patient. If we move together, we will do a good job. So again, just to encapsulate what we have said so far, if it is fasting hyperglycemia alone, then basal insulin will be a good choice. If it is postprandial hyperglycemia, then you can use premixed or you can use intensive therapy. If it is both, then you have to use intensive or premixed. It will depend upon the patient's requirements and the patient's willingness. If the HbA1c is low at presentation, below 8.5, then basal may work. But usually our patients do not come to us so early. And even if they do come to us early, they are not going to accept insulin so early. So if the HbA1c is above 8.5, we will have to start a dual action insulin, that is premixed or basal bolus. Remember that in ACE, the American Association of Clinical Endocrinologists, at HbA1c more than 7.5, they suggest dual oral therapy to begin with. If you look in terms of insulin, then also it means you need dual action insulin, both basal and prandial. And like I said, you cannot have the canary separate and the canara separate. They have to go together.
CFAM, caring for well-being.